Hi, I'm Don Sackett, co-founder of SciAps, and I am here with my favorite software director, who is going to show all of you this great fleet management system, and in the cloud. Can I say it's in the cloud?
Yes, you can say it in the cloud.
Okay, all
yeah,
right.
You forgot to introduce me.
I did say you're just my favorite software director, Katerina Dudkin.
Yeah, so hello everyone. I'm a software manager here at SciAps.
Director,
yes, I got recently promoted. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Yes, and here we're talking about cloud. What is cloud? Cloud is an application for fleet management. So you have a lot of analyzers, you can connect them to our fleet management solution, and you could monitor data coming from analyzers in real time. Also, what you could do, you could get some statistics from your device, you could do export management, we have advanced user management system, and I just want to show you some functionality here.
Can I ask you a question before you do this? So, for example, if I'm a quality assurance guy and I've got 30 guys all around the world, they're all doing testing, testing materials, making sure they're right. As the manager, I could log in and look at the results and pull the results from any of those analyzers anytime.
Correct.
Is that right?
Yes.
Okay,
so
that's a very powerful tool.
So you not only can monitor them at real time, but you also can collect device logs if something goes wrong. You can compare tests side by side, so you could see like if chemistry is off on one of the units. Mm. You could also monitor failures on the device, which is good for troubleshooting.
Oh, failures, I see.
Yes. So for example, like some reasons, right? Mm-hmm. And we can collect all the data, and we could also push software updates.
That's very important.
What I want to show you right now is that what devices we support. As you can see here, we have XRF and LIPS models.
Yep.
You could click on each of them and you could see what applications are supported. You could type serial number, register your device, and assign to a particular account.
Okay. So every model we make is cloud enabled.
Every model is cloud enabled. We do.
Didn't I just say that?
Yeah, you did. Yeah, it's a good statement because we share code and the same protocol used for all device types.
Cool.
It's very important because it's so easy to add a new model, which happens all the time at SciAps.
We constantly innovate,
which is great, right? And that's why, you know, recently, for example, we came up with a powerhouse, right?
Oh, it's a beautiful analyzer. Look at that.
It's cloud enabled, so you can upload the data.
Yep.
And see it in real time.
Our rare earth analyzer, heavy rare earths, beautiful.
Yeah, we spent so much time working on it.
Yeah.
It's looking great.
Yep.
Okay,
so
what I'll do right now, I have two analyzers here.
Okay.
They both registered on my account. I log in as my user.
Oh, so this is where people, like, if I want to see if my guys are doing good testing or they're testing at all.
Testing at all, by the way, you see online status, that means that it's online, right?
So I know that unit's been turned on, it's connected to the cloud.
And you can upload the data from them.
Okay. And can I get real time? Like, let me show you something.
Wait, hold on a second.
All right. You got to log in.
So which one are you going to use?
I'm going to use the LIPS.
Okay. So we're using LIPS. So I could click on LIPS analyzer. Mm-hmm. And here's the currently what was uploaded from this analyzer.
Right.
The list of test results.
Yep.
So now you can take a test.
Okay. So this is what we call our CSI analyzer. It's laser based. And it only measures carbon and silicon in stainless and steels, and I think maybe nickels. And the reason we made this analyzer is because there's a lot of XRF owners out there. And as you all know, X-ray can't measure carbon. Do you know that?
Yeah,
nope. I do. X-ray can't measure carbon. So we made an analyzer that was less expensive than a full-blown LIBS that customers could buy if they just wanted to add carbon testing to their capability. So for a lot less money, they could use their existing XRF and their new CSI, and they can do the full range of PMI work. But anyway, enough about that. Just to show you how this thing works, turn it on, hit analyze. All right, so we're gonna see a test pop up there in real time, right?
Yep.
See, there's no cables, nothing going on. This is a L grade, I don't know what this is. Coming on in, all right, so
test.
I'm going to do
three. Yeah, yeah, here we go. 142.
I'm going to do three tests. It's reading.
133.
Reading, yep.
You have to press save button.
Press save button, thank you.
You're welcome.
I always wonder how to use these things.
I just want to remind that this mod is like we upload results included into averaging, and at the end of the carbon sequence, yep, we calculate average results. So you could see that this one is average,
yeah,
result.
So it should 0.029%. Yeah, yep, there it is. Yep, plus 0.003. There you go.
Yeah.
Very
and
nice.
We also show results included into averaging calculation, and you could see here
individual
which
ones
tests were included.
All right.
So it's pretty cool, right?
It
so
is.
So I just want to show something that is really nice. So for example,
let me just summarize, because so basically people. You got a bunch of guys in the field. You can make sure they're doing their work. You can look at their tests in real time, especially for carbon where sample prep and grinding is so important. You can really make sure they're getting, you can tell them, hey, go test these standards first. I want to look at the results. So you can really make sure they're properly doing the sample prep and properly doing the testing so they don't come back after several days of work and you find out a lot of what was wrong. So that's a huge, that's a really important feature for especially for PMI, because carbon's not an easy thing to do in terms of testing, and there's a lot of less than perfect sample prep. So the fact that I think you can see immediately that your inspectors are doing good testing on carbon is a big advantage.
Yeah.
So, yeah. All
and
right.
If at any point you need to compare the results,
yeah,
side by side,
mm-hmm,
you could select them and you could choose compare function.
Okay.
It's nice that you could move them side by side so you could definitely see the sequence.
Oh, these are all your different tests. I
yeah,
see. Yep.
Yeah,
yep.
So you can compare and see what's going on. You
okay
can open individual test,
mm-hmm,
right?
Yeah.
And inspect it.
Can
example
you even set up a little template so you can print a report right away?
Yeah, you could.
Okay.
You could also look at the spectrum. we could look at another spectrum.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, well, that's an X-ray spectrum. That's so
X-ray
much nicer.
It's so much nicer. Yeah, and you could also look at in full screen view.
Yeah, nice.
Yes.
All right, that's beautiful.
That's beautiful, yes.
Do anything else you need to?
Yeah, I just want to talk a little
there's
bit.
Always something.
Like, yeah, it's always something, and I know. But I want to show capability of the software update. So what you could do,
right, yeah.
You could choose what to upload. So we could push configuration to this analyzer. So we not only could push software update, but we also could push some other configuration files. For example, if you want to change the license, you could do it. If you want to add some specific user information, because we support advanced user management, you could push user configuration files that will be sent immediately to analyzer.
Okay.
And from there, you could accept the software update. Same way as you do on your phone. On your
so you don't have to
phone
send your instrument back anymore. You don't have to
no,
wait for
a
technician to come out and
yeah
upload. Very
also
nice.
What we have bug reports. On analyzer, we added a new feature that allows you to
you always told me your software didn't have bugs.
That's not our box.
Back
right
to manager.
Yeah, let's blame electrical and mechanical engineers.
Okay, all right.
I like
all
doing
right
that. So we support a bug report feature that allows not only like for customer to report some issue, but also upload logs.
Yeah.
Logs are very critical for us. So and we
oh, for debugging in the field.
For debugging. Right. So you get the right log here right away. You could look at it. You see like if something goes wrong.
And over time, we could even put some analytics in here that could say, oh, we're looking at your data, we notice these trends, you
yeah
might want to have a service call sometime.
Exactly.
So you can kind of, almost predictive maintenance, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's very important.
Very good. Very nice.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, well, you're welcome. You did a heck of a job. It was really nice. All right.
Okay. Bye-bye, guys.